Hello, Facebook Live. Don't get too excited. This isn't a show. This is a test. I spent all day yesterday till late in the night figuring out, learning, and then setting up how to do titles here on Facebook Live. The Wirecast system here can do live titles. And in all the years I've been using it, I never bothered to learn them until Marty Sulloway embarrassed me by doing them on his system. He's got nothing better to do. He's not producing any episodes. Well, he's at camp now. Sterling, where's your Phasing Line podcast? It's the late in July. Do you know where your Phasing Line podcast is? He's newlywed. Okay, so here, and I'm really excited about it, except for one thing. There's a problem to solve, but I was all set up to sit here and do this, so I'm doing it here. And the real issue will be it's a lot of buttons to push. Will I remember what buttons to push? But here's what we can do. I'm hoping this works. Oh, look, it even did the zoom in of the big logo. And here's the problem. I'm pushing the buttons that should... I had to push that button a lot. It should work the first time. And then it fades in. And that thing is in the wrong position, and it shouldn't be. So, let's see. I can fade that out. I've got my name, David's name. A lot of button pushing. This may be a problem. You know, can I push all these buttons and still do a show? That's probably why I haven't done this before now. Second guest's name, third guest's name. Got the fundraising title, or making people mad. We can do that fundraising title, or I can just talk about the Begging for Funding Foundation, which sooner or later is going to go away because, you know, it's a small joke. And I think that's it. Oh, and also the little bug. It's so much more helpful to have it on the screen in front of me instead of trying to guess where these things are, because I can see them. That's called a bug in the business. Just kind of a semi-transparent thing that sits there that if someone wants to use one of my interviews and doesn't want you to know that it came from me, they've got to cover that up somehow. Makes them work a little bit harder. I'm always happy to let people know where footage comes from. Usually I do it by including, it's usually YouTube, and I'll make it in a small box and you can see the YouTube stuff around it. All right, so there's this disappointment. And I'll spend some time maybe this afternoon trying to figure that out. If not, we'll suffer with it until I can figure out what's going on. I took hours yesterday trying to figure out how to make this part work properly. Ordinary titles like this are easy. Bring in a specific type of graphic file. It's called a PNG. It's got the thing about this file is you can see me behind it. In theory, it's a full screen's worth of black and then the title. Things in graphics have always had that difficulty. How do you make something that's going to see behind? So they worked on that back in the early days of digital video and analog video for a long time. So it's this PNG file has what they call transparency, and the stuff you want in the foreground is there, and then there's some data in it that says, and anything that's not what we're specifying as being in the foreground, let the background shine through, and that's easy to do. What wasn't wasn't so easy to do was to find a file that would do that, a video file that would do it. And I looked for some instructions online and got some recommendations for a specific type of file, and I tried it first, and it didn't work. Wirecast says, I don't know what kind of file that is. I can't use that. It was a QuickTime movie file using something called the animation codec. No, can't use codec 2 for, sorry, can't do that for this. Could use it for the audio if you wanted the show to sound like this. Somebody suggested they liked the idea yesterday when I was doing the show through the transceiver. They liked the whole show going through sideband. I don't think you'd like it for very long, though. The animation codec didn't work the first time. So I tried a bunch of other codecs, and some had the transparency, but they made huge files, and some did fine, but Wirecast didn't know what they were, wouldn't import them. And then I tried one more time with the animation codec, and this is it. It worked. Got to push the buttons a lot. What's the story here? No, it's not working at all. Oh, I've got to turn it off before we'll run it. It's going to be so complicated. Hi, guest. I'm pleased to have you on the show, and I've got many insightful questions and some interesting commentary and conversation to have with you, but I'm not going to be able to get to any of that because I'm going to be busy trying to figure out how to make my Wirecast run. I'm practicing doing these things while I'm looking at the camera and not paying attention to the keyboard. My name is not David Goldenberg. My name is Gary Pierce, KN4AQ. And now here's my co-host, David Goldenberg. And I'll switch up his shot. He would normally appear in this window. And now I don't want dissolves. The other thing I did in some of that time was I set up some other types of shots. You've seen, you know, there's me and there's this Skype appears in this monitor. And so this shot is just that monitor. And if I've got multiple people in Skype, I need to do some things so that I can appear in one little spot and that multiple people appear across the monitor like that. So that's how that would work. And then the other day I had Jeff in the studio sitting in that chair. Oops, let me get that off of there. Okay, he was sitting in the chair there in front of that little table. So he was, you know, right over my shoulder. Sort of see that. I was also working. Oh, nice hair. I was working on getting color balance between the cameras a little bit better. So that's what that shot was pointed right to me. But you can see where Jeff was. He was right next to me. So I wanted to be able to set up some shots that you could have me next to the person on Skype, but I couldn't put Jeff next to that person. So now that camera can also show up there. And if we were to be doing this shot, I've also set it up so that, let's see. Yeah. So that when you see my angle like that, that's the guest. Camera should be pointed over there. So I could do it like with me or with the studio guest or I remembered. Or both of us. This is practically CNN. It's way ahead of Fox News. And then there's this three shot. And I noticed that in the three shot, my picture would jump a little bit. And so I fixed that. I fixed it. What else have I got here? Let's see. And the color went all cattywampus on that. These are the little, that's the micro cam. That's this one sitting here, Logitech. And they don't hold their adjustments very well. Anything else? I don't think so. Now I need to do a show. What I don't have is the end animation. For those few of you who have made it all the way to the end of any one of our shows, any one of our long shows, you remember how they go. We say over and out. And then this ARVN thing comes flying in from the edges of the screen and disappears, or, you know, we disappear in the ARVN, Amateur Radio Video News, the most important ham radio television network on the internet. It sits there for a minute. It's the original logo, which was 4x3 television. It squishes itself out or stretches itself out to 16x9. and then it clicked off with a clever little animation. If you've never made it to the end of the show, you'll at least want to fast forward yourself. Can I do that for you? It's getting harder and harder to do because the ends of the show is pretty much no longer the end of the show. I'll have to go back in history to find one that just ends. Not sure how far back I have to go because I've just been putting funny stuff at the end. I think there won't be anything else in that one. Hey, David.
Good morning, Gary.
We're doing it live again.
Yes, we are.
Pretty exciting.
Live and on Facebook.
So this. Okay, so let's see what happens here.
Someone saying, that's bad radio procedure.
And they explained very carefully in great detail what over meant and what out meant and how they were incompatible. And so I say that all the time now. So we, when we have three people,
let's see what
we
happens.
Sign everyone a word. Jeff, I'm going to sign you the word and David, I'll let you kick it off.
I still may be screwing around at the end of this. I don't know.
Everybody, and thank you so much, Jeff. Everybody have a great weekend. Over.
And.
Out.
I think we've done like an hour show here.
Just screwed around with it again.
This is the Rambling Podcast.
Yeah, that's what I'm thinking of doing. It's just, you know, the never-ending ham radio show. And I'll just have a continuing succession. And then, you know, when I got to go to sleep, I'll hand it off to another host. We'll just pick it up and keep on going. And sooner or later, we're going to end up with Bob Heil here. Yeah.
So convincing. Trying to figure out what... Okay, that's the way it's supposed to end. Yeah, and just ends there. And then YouTube, hopefully... sends you off to something else. But
this is Ham Radio Now's
totally out of control. So I got to go back even farther, back into history, so that show just ends without being goofy. Now, once again, if you haven't been... Wait. That button. Once again, if you haven't been... watching the show to the very end, then you haven't seen all this clever stuff.
I just thought of the title for the show just seconds ago.
Okay, let me see how this ends.
ARVN logo thing at the end of Facebook because I don't have any title set up. So you just see me reach over here
and click the goodbye button.
Okay, so that's a standard show ending.
Facebook.
Back when I was being boring.
Don't have any titles set up, so you just see me reach over here and click the goodbye button. Bye.
Click. All right, so for those of you that never made it to the end of a show, now apparently you do, because not only do we do that, and I'm not looking at you. The heck are you trying to do? Bluegrass Media. Building a GoBox.
Hey there, YouTube. Chris from Bluegrass Media here. And today I'm going to be doing something I've never done before. I'm going to try my hand at painting.
So Chris from Bluegrass Media has yet to invest in any audio equipment. He's just rolling his camera, and he's got the little microphone stuck on the camera. So
it's out to paint it, but hopefully when it's done, it's going to look pretty good. This is kind of a rush job because tomorrow it's going to be on display at a public safety.
Let's get to the end and see how he did.
All right.
I think he's got a scanner going off in the background
okay,
there.
Okay, that's in. Now there's just one final test. Will it close? And it's in.
Yeah, he's more ambitious than I am.
It's in. Okay, now, there's one other final test. Will it power on?
Yeah, I might turn the scanner off in the background when you do a show. I might, but it's kind of interesting.
Fans come on. Test the radio.
Can't really judge the paint job very well.
Oh, I forgot to hook up the microphone. Hopefully I can just do it.
Well, this is a warts and all. I approve.
Oh, please, let me be able to plug this thing in.
Okay, guys, notice the ham radio now bug that's on the screen, as it should be.
All right, microphone is in. Oh, I just have to put the antenna on real quick.
That too.
Test the antenna fitting. Now let's just do a real quick check. KI4 RDG.
But are you going to show us the paint job?
I just keyed up a local repeater. This box is not connected to anything external. It is completely on its own power. All right, here's the finished
product.
And
there we go, yeah. Oh, it's like...
a close-up of the...
it's got some shading to it.
Control panel and the radio.
Got fans.
As you can see, the...
switches.
I don't know if you can make it on camera, but the paint didn't turn out all that great. It's got a lot of defects.
Oh, dear.
And it's already chipping away in some areas.
He just painted it.
The fact that this doesn't have a clear coat on it is probably a big factor.
Well?
But I just didn't have time. This has to be on display at an event.
Oh, great.
In the morning. And it's 1:30 a.m. right now.
Yeah, that sounds like me.
I'm going to get maybe 2 hours of sleep tonight. Here's the other side of it.
Okay, so... I'm
really happy with...
Bluegrass Media. What else have you done, Bluegrass Media? A lot. But apparently not a lot of ham radio. You can watch an airplane take off. This is the airplane I learned... You notice I've never done an intro like that, and I never will. Never will. I have a pilot's license, and I learned to fly in Cessna 172s just like that, starting with a 150. 150 is a two-seat airplane. 172 is a four-seat airplane. little heavier. It flies like a truck. Something about this is not fast, so... It's loud, though. I'm holding the volume down to spare your ears. Yeah, I don't know if you can read that gas price in the background is $5 and something. I'm not sure when this was, but aviation fuel has always been about double. Or more. Look, up in the sky, it's a bird. It's a plane. It is a plane. Sweet.
180 horsepower engine. If it was 160, it would take longer.
Okay. Other aircraft activity.
He's going to do an engine run up. Okay. Here.
All right. I'm not totally bored because I like looking at airplane stuff, but I got to go to lunch. So, once again, can I push the buttons right? I am Gary Pierce, KN4AQ, 73, Facebook out.